بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن نبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، أهلا وسهلا ومرحبا. Welcome, my brothers in Islam, to lesson 213, 213, من العربية بين يديك, book 1, part 1 of the new version. وقفنا أيها الإخوة عند صفحة 146 عند التدريب الخامس. حول كما في المثال, change like in the example. المثال: أحمد يستيقظ مبكرا. الطالب الثاني: استيقظ أنت مبكرا. إذن ما هو المطلوب من هذا التدريب؟ What is required or requested from this exercise? أحمد يستيقظ مبكرا. أحمد wakes up early. استيقظ أنت مبكرا. Wake up you early. كما ترون أيها الإخوة أن الفعل في الجملة الأولى فعل مضارع، وأن الفعل في الجملة الثانية فعل أمر. إذن أيها الإخوة، المطلوب what is required or requested in the exercise في التدريب: تحويل الفعل المضارع changing the present tense verb إلى فعل أمر to a command verb، مع اختيار اسم لكل صورة with choosing a name for every picture. إذن أيها الإخوة، مثلا for example الصورة الأولى: خالد يقرأ القرآن. خالد is reading القرآن. إذن هذا فعل مضارع. It's a present tense verb. How do we say to somebody read the Quran؟ اقرأ أنت القرآن. وأريد أن أذكر لكم. So أريد أن أذكر لكم. نعم. قبل أن أذكر هذا الأمر, before I mention this thing, استيقظ is a فعل أمر كما ترون, as you can see, للمفرد المذكري for the single masculine form بإخراج طرف اللسان with taking out the edge of the tongue. استيقظ. Wake up. But this is for the single form masculine. As for استيقظي يعني أنت, استيقظا you two. Whether two male, two female, one male, one female. استيقظوا is wake up you lot. استيقظنا. استيقظنا. يعني with the كسرة below the قاف is wake up you lot feminine. One of the things that you brothers might have seen and might have noticed is the enter, because normally we don't put a detached pronoun after the فعل أمر. استيقظ. استيقظ مبكرا. Wake up early. It's already the you form. So what is this أنت all about? أنت ضمير منفصل. It's a detached pronoun. منفصل is detached. وعكسه متصل. It's opposite is متصل. للتوكيد, for emphasis. إذن when I say for emphasis, it shows that it's allowed to drop it. استيقظ مبكرا. Wake up early. So what does استيقظ أنت مبكرا means? it means also wake up early, but it's just a bit stronger because it's kind of repetition. It's like you're repeating the pronoun, you're repeating the person. It's just like you say to somebody, stand up, that's strong enough, and then you make it a bit strong, stand up you. You just emphasize it. إذن ويجوز حذفه, it's allowed to delete it. So using the استخدام الضمير المنفصل بعد فعل أمر جائز, is allowed. Using the detached pronoun after the command verb is allowed. قال اليهود لموسى عليه السلام, the Jews, because يهوديون is one Jew, this is the plural, الجمع. قال اليهود, the Jews, they said لموسى, to موسى عليه السلام, peace be upon him, قالوا يا موسى إنا لن ندخلها أبدا ما داموا فيها فاذهب. هذا فعل أمر, command, so go. It's already you form. Fadhab. It's normally idhab, but the fa, what means so? Fadhab. And this is the emphasis damir. Okay? After the fadhab, what is a fi'lu amri? Fadhab anta wa rabbuka faqatila inna hahuna qa'idun. They, the Jews, they said, O Musa, we shall never enter it as long as they are there. So go you and your Lord and fight, you two, we are sitting right here. Allahu musta'an. نسيت أن أذكر رقم الآية. I forgot to mention the number of the ayah. أظن أنها في سورة المائدة. I think that it's in سورة المائدة. والله أعلم. So this is what the Jews said to Musa, to the Prophet Musa عليه السلام, in disobedience. So فَذْهَبْ وَرَبُّكَ. It's enough, but they wanted to emphasize their disobedience. So they said, فَذْهَبْ أَنْتَ وَرَبُّكَ. طيب؟ نعم. إذن أيها الإخوة, يمكنكم حذف هذا الضمير في بقية الصور. You can delete this pronoun in the remaining or the rest of the pictures. ابدأوا الآن. Start now. إذا كنت وحدك افعل الجملتين. If you're alone, then do the two sentences. بسم الله. إذن أيها الإخوة, سأسميهم جميعا. I will call them, I will name them, all of them, جميعا, all of them. سأسميهم خالدا. I will call all of them خالد. إذن خالد يقرأ القرآن. اقرأ القرآن. اقرأ القرآن. So somebody might say, is it right what I'm hearing? I hear اقرأي, and a command verb is a سكون, اقرأ. But the reply will be, this is التقاء الساكنين, the meeting of two سكونs, and then the first سكون gets a كسرة. Okay, اقرأ will become اقرأي with a كسرة below the stick. اقرأ القرآن. And سبحان الله, الذي أظن, what I think, أن مؤلفي هذا الكتاب أرادوا لكم التسهيل. That the authors of this book, they wanted for you lot easiness. Because when you put, لأنك عندما تضع الضمير المنفصل عندما تضع الضمير المنفصل لا تجد التقاء ساكنين. You will not find the meeting of two sukuns by putting the anta. So that's why they saved you بإذن الله the headache of the التقاء الساكنين by putting the anta in each one. Because if I use the anta here, اقرأ with the crystal clear sukun, اقرأ أنت القرآن. Okay? اقرأ أنت القرآن. But by dropping the anta, القرآن has al التعريف, al of definition, and the lam has a sukun because the weak hamza of al is not pronounced. So we have the lam of al Quran, which has a sukun. We have another sukun on the hamza of iqra, and this is called iltiqa al-sakinaini, the meeting of two sukuns. Okay, so I think that this was maybe the intention of mentioning this anta to make it easy for you, my brothers in Islam. Okay, they just want you to know that the fi'l amr has sukun. They don't want to tell you at this stage that the fi'l amr, although having a sukun, it can have a kasra when there is iltiqa' al-sakinayn. Idan, Khalidun yantadiru al-hafilata. Khalid is waiting for the bus. Intadiri al-hafilata, with a kasra below the ra. Or intadir anta al-hafilata, the easy way with the sukun on the ra. And نعم خالد يكنس الغرفة. Khalid is hovering or vacuuming the room, and it can also be brooming or sweeping depending on what you use, the old way or the new way. اكنس أنت الغرفة or اكنس الغرفة, broom or vacuum the room. خالد يغسل الملابس. خالد is washing the clothes. اغسل أنت الملابس. Wash you the clothes. Wash the clothes. You don't have to say wash you the clothes. It doesn't sound correct. It's just wash the clothes. Or اغسل الملابس. But then you have to put the كسرة below the lam. خالد يأكل التمر. خالد is eating dates. كما تعلمون التمر جمع والمفرد the single form is تمرة بالتاء المربوطة. كل التمر, eat the dates. Or كل أنت التمر. نعم. So, نعم. خالد يشاهد التلفاز. خالد is watching TV. وكما تعلمون, as you know, L doesn't mean always the. So it's just Khalid is watching TV. طيب, if I drop the L, it will be Khalid يشاهد التلفازا. He's watching a TV. So the whole meaning becomes blurry. It becomes kind of unclear. He's watching a TV. So keep the L. Khalid's watching TV. شاهد أنت التلفاز أو شاهد التلفاز. نعم. هذا التدريب مفيد جدا. It's very beneficial. لأن فيه التحويل, because in it is changement, من المضارع إلى الأمر, from the present tense to the future tense, to the command tense, the order verb. وأيضا فيه تمرين على المفعول به. Also there is an exercise in it to understand the مفعول به, the object, because it's all objects here. الملابس, التمر, التلفاز, الغرفة, الحافلة, القرآن. So all the verb plus the what question takes you to a fatha. He's reading what? القرآن. And even in the command verb, read what? You command me to do what? Okay? Wait for what? Wait for the bus. Vacuum what? Vacuum the room. So, as you can see, my brothers in Islam, this is a very good exercise to understand the مفعول به, Now, it just shows you how much grammar there is in this book, subhanAllah. We have الفعل المضارع, فعل أمر, المفعول به. This all pure grammar, but in a very nice, soft way. And this is something special about this book. They teach you grammar in an easy way. In the top of the tadrib, we have also grammar. They show you what ila does to the noun after. Ila al-masjidi, ila al-madrasati, ila al-bayti. So you will learn that ila is powerful and it's a preposition. It gives a kasra to the noun after. So this all grammar, brothers in Islam. الصفحة التالية, the next page, ملخص التراكيب, a summary of the compositions. A summary of the compositions. And when you see this page, my brothers in Islam, you have to remind this sentence, اغلقوا الكتب, close the books. وترجموا الجمل التالية, and translate, you lot, الجمل التالية, the following sentences. So when you see this page, you know that you are in a test. And you are going to test yourself, inshallah. This is a very important test. So I think that all books are closed now. أحضروا ورقة وأحضروا قلما. Take out a paper. ورقة فارغة. An empty paper, وقلماً, and a pen or pencil. وابدأ الآن, and start now. نعم. عفواً, the window is open. النافذة مفتوحة, فهناك شيء من الضجيج. There is some noise من الخارج, from the outside. Where do you pray الفجر? اكتب بالعربية واكتب بالشكل. Where do you pray al-Fajr? Where do you pray al-Dhuhr? استخدموا the pause button. Use the pause button. Where do you pray al-Dhuhr? Where do you pray al-Asr? Where do you pray al-Maghrib? Where do you pray al-Isha? Where do you pray al-Jumu'ah? I'm going to the masjid. I'm going to the school. I'm going to the house. Actually, I'm going home. And Afwan, I want you to use the noun form. And if you have written the verb form, what's adhabu, that is fine as well, but I prefer you to use the noun form. And then we have, I'm going to the masjid, I'm going to the school, I'm going home, I'm going to the doctor, I'm going to the doctor. I'm going to Mecca. Put the alarm clock next to you. put the Quran next to you. يعني next to you mail. So when I mention a sentence, it's always masculine unless I mention it's feminine. So we have عندنا, put the alarm clock next to you, put the Quran next to you, put the book next to you. Put or place the newspaper next to you. Put or place the glasses or spectacles next to you. I pray al-Fajr in the Masjid al-Haram. I pray al-Dhuhr in the Masjid al-Nabawi. I pray al-Asr in Masjid Bilal. I pray al-Maghrib in Masjid Bilal. I pray al-Isha. I pray al-Isha in Masjid Uthman. I pray al-Jumu'ah in Masjid Ali. الجدول التالي, the next table or schedule, وهو أهم جدول في هذه الصفحة, and it's the most important schedule in this page, as you will hear now, inshallah. He wakes up. Wake up. Okay, so we have present tense, فعل مضارع, ثم then فعل أمر, a command verb. So you quickly switch. You write down he wakes up and then you write wake up, a command for the masculine form. Okay, so don't put a ya at the end of the command verb to make it feminine. Keep it masculine. He's listening. Listen. He is reading. Read. He is putting or placing. Put. He is waiting. Wait. He is hoovering or vacuuming or brooming. Hoover. He is washing. Wash. He is viewing or watching. Watch. He is eating. Eat. الجدول الأخير, the last schedule or table. Why are you traveling to Mecca? And I don't want the verb, what is تسافروا, you're traveling, I want the noun form, the اسم فاعل. It's all in the masculine form. Why are you traveling to Mecca? Why is he traveling to Al-Madina?
Why are you feminine traveling using the ism fa'il? Why are you feminine traveling to Egypt? والجملة الأخيرة, the last sentence. Why is she traveling to Turkey? افتحوا الكتب, open the books. وصححوا هذا التمرين and mark this exercise. أتمنى أن تكون الأخطاء قليلة. I hope that the mistakes are a little. وجزاكم الله خيرا. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.